Many people, myself included, view Majora's Mask as one of their all-time favorite Zelda games, and a prime example of how games should handle their side quests, world building, and character development. Most of this remains true with its remake for the 3DS, and while a lot of the changes to that version of the game were good, there are also valid criticisms for many of these changes. In this video, we're going to look at what went wrong with Majora's Mask 3D, and what the game would need changed or fixed before an HD re-release or remake. Comment below and let us know which game you would like us to cover next, or what you loved and hated the most about Majora's Mask 3D. Before we begin on what a lot of fans may interpret as senselessly hating on one of their favorite games, that isn't the case at all. Look, the average Metacritic score from pretty much all reviewers is an 89%, and many would even rate it higher than that. There are good changes to the game. I liked that Grezzo added compatibility with the new 3DS model, and finally having a second analog stick, or in this case the little C-stick nubbin, to control the camera is a great addition. Mixing up a few of the mask locations and side quests was a surprise as well. I would actually have loved to see a sort of master quest or second playthrough, giving us remixed dungeons, and maybe remixing some of the side quests and what time they take place to throw us off our feet, and not being able to rely just on memory. Similar to how playing through Ocarina of Time and memorizing every dungeon 100% perfectly will basically be useless when navigating the Master Quest's remix dungeons in that game. The overall graphical improvements are pretty good, and the Bomber's Notebook is a welcome change for the most part for many fans, as well as the Song of Double Time giving you more precise control when skipping forward through time. There are genuinely good changes made here. So why does Majora's Mask receive a lot of complaints? More than the original or other remasters or remakes in the series? One of the biggest points is the boss fights. All of the boss fights were changed a fair bit by adding an obvious eyeball weak point. Odolwa, the first boss, was completely nerfed, removing the variety of methods that you could employ to attack him. Twinmold is completely changed, with the Giant's Mask mechanics being overhauled entirely. I know Nintendo and Grezzo wanted to make it easier and more accessible, especially for younger players, but one of the major purposes of the original game, as stated by Aonuma, was for it to be a lot more challenging, and meant to be for players who were essentially experts on the mechanics, gameplay, puzzle solving, and fighting systems of Ocarina of Time. With only 4 main dungeon bosses, most people want them to feel more challenging in order for it to feel as big of an accomplishment as completing all of the other dungeons in other Zelda games. The next point that comes to mind is the way the transformation masks are handled, the Zora mask likely being the most irritating. Holding A makes you swim, while you need to hold R to perform the original method of swimming faster, and it automatically activates the electric shield around Link, rapidly draining your magic meter. When running out of magic, Zora Link will only gain a short, small boost, essentially tying a previous ability to swim faster to your magic meter. The normal method of Deku Link's movement received a downgrade as well. Hopping across water will completely throw off players of the original, since Deku Link will defy physics and somehow lose all momentum as soon as his foot makes contact with the water. Goron Link now attacks faster, which kind of throws off the balancing since he's supposed to be slow but strong, but otherwise he remains mostly the same. Nintendo stated they wanted to add amiibo support to the game but couldn't decide on what they would do, so they took the design for the Skull Kid amiibo and just made him a collectible statue to go along with the game. I personally can think of a few that wouldn't really ruin anything. Having an amiibo slightly rewind time, refill hearts, magic meter, arrows, bombs, and other things would have been completely optional. How great would it have been to have amiibo of each transformation mask alongside the Skull Kid amiibo? You could also look to how Twilight Princess HD's amiibo functionality works, with an extra hard mode being unlocked with Ganondorf's amiibo and item restocks for the rest. When the game does eventually become remade for HD consoles, hopefully, we hope Nintendo is able to fix most of, if not all of those unnecessary changes.
When it comes to the two fishing ponds, honestly, great. The more minigames or things in general they add to the game, the better. But I would have been just as happy with one larger fishing pond and a completely different type of minigame. Or if they took the time to develop more bonus masks or side quests instead of a second fishing pond.
But please comment below and let us know what you loved or hated about Majora's Mask 3D. Was anything wrong with the original that you wish would have been changed but wasn't? Let us know down below, and thank you so much for watching. Hope you all have a lovely rest of your day. Bye bye.
And of course, I want to give a huge thank you to all of our Patreon supporters who give us video ideas like this, some of our Zelda Theory top 10 list, and discussion topics that we discuss on our podcast or other videos. If you would like a shout out at the end of all of our videos or the beginning of our podcast, the Hylian Gamescast, as well as any of the other benefits mentioned. So thank you, Jon Snow, Zane, Fran, Wiggly Wiggle, Nod Narb, or Brandon, Sober X, Mr. Monoclad, Metroid, Jen, Super NX, 64, David, Zoe, Natsu, Jesse, Andremoy, Ashton, Justin, Candy, Chad, BKRS7, Lerulean Sheep, Largnar, Monica, Shadow to Us, Rusty, Lovable Christy, Henry, and of course, Gus.